Hello, dear students. So, welcome to our class. So, we are now here again in our subject, Understanding Culture, Society, and Politics. And take note, we are now on, let me share to you first my slides, my PowerPoint. So, there you go. So, nakikita nyo naman siguro ang aking screen at nakikita nyo na rin siguro ang subject natin, which is Understanding Culture, Society, and Politics. And we are now here on module number 7 or week number 7. So, let's begin. So, we are going to study we are going to talk on this lesson, state and non-state institutions. So, ano nga ba yung state and non-state institutions? So, before anything else, allow me to share to you or to present to you our most essential learning competency, which is explain the forms and functions of state and non-state institutions. And the following objectives are cite the similarities and differences of state and non-state institutions. Identify the different non-state institutions. Discuss the role and functions of state and non-state institutions in the society. Ano kaya yung function nila? Ano yung tungkulin nila sa ating society? Value the importance of state and non-state institutions. So, alam niyo na yung importance, I mean the role and functions. So, what do you think are or is the importance of these institutions? And lastly, analyze the different roles, functions of the different state institutions or non-state institutions to the people. So, let's start with state. Alam niyo naman siguro ang state, we have been talking this in the previous weeks, both in politics and governance and also in this subject, UCSP. So when I say state, it is an organized political community living under a single system of government. So hindi ko na tatalakayin ngayon yung different elements of state kasi tinalakay na natin yun sa isa nating subject, which is politics and governance. Okay. And often state and government are used as synonyms. Both words refer to an organized political group that exercises authority over a territory, over a territory. So there's always a territory in a state. Okay. So, the term state can also refer to the secular branches of government within a state, often as a manner of contrasting them with churches and civilian institutions. Okay? So, usually, ang lagi kong sinasabi dito, kapag sinabing state, these are government, okay, government institutions. So, ano-ano kaya yung mga government institutions? Ang daming mga government institutions. Okay? Like school, it is a government institution. Public school is a government institution. Okay? It's a government institution rather, I'm sorry. So, now let's move on to different non-state institutions. So, when we say non-state institutions, these are establishments which are not owned and controlled by the government. Take note, sinabi ko kanina, when we say state, usually these are government institutions. So most probably, dahil government institution siya, pag-aari ito and controlled by the government. But in the other one, which is the non-state institutions, this is not controlled and owned by the government. So, papasok na doon ngayon yung mga different private institutions. So, non-state institutions, some non-state institutions are for profit and others are non-profits, and some are for personal investments and for financial help. So meaning to say, naitatag yung mga different non-state institutions because it could be founded by a group of people na ang layunin lang nila is to earn profit, okay? For profit purpose, okay? Pero there are some institutions naman na itinatag sila because they are willing to help, okay? They are willing to help specific type of people. Like for example, yung mga inaabuso, yung mga inaabuso ng mga asawa, something like that, or mga babaeng biktima ng karahasan, something like that. Or minsan naman, mga group organization naman na maaaring itinatag because they wanted to help save the planet Earth. Okay? So anything and everything. So one example of non-state institution is banks. Okay? So these are places or institutions where people place or deposit money or savings with corresponding interest on a given and or assets for safekeeping. Banks plays an important role as an intermediary or go-between in the financial system. Okay? So alam niyo naman siguro ang pinaka-main reason or main functions ng mga banks. Okay? So there are three main functions of banks. Una, for deposit. Okay? For depository savings. Number two, responsible for payment system. You notice you can even make payments through banks. Okay? Like for example, kapag nagbayad ka ng bahay mo na inuupa na binabayaran mo through Pag-ibig, usually ang transaction doon through banks, di ba? And another one, number three, banks issue loans. Both people and company. Nagpapautang din yung mga bangko. Okay? So, ito yung mga tatlong to, yung three main reasons kung bakit naitatag yung mga different banks in the Philippines. Okay. One more is corporations. Okay? Have you heard about different corporations in the Philippines? Mayroon ba kayong alam ng mga different corporations? Napakarami, di ba? Napakaraming korporasyon sa Pilipinas. Baka maalala niyo sila if you will only listen to our discussion now. A corporation is a company of group of people authorized to act as a single entity, legally a person, and recognized as such in law. Okay? So usually kapag corporation, it is a kind of company owned by a group of people. It could be members of the family. It could be your friends. Then you will magtatatag kayo ng corporation. Okay? Corporation is a legal entity created under state law and is designed to generate a profit. Yun na nga. So you will establish corporation para magkaroon kayo ng profit. Diba? Corporations come in many different types but usually divided by the law of the jurisdictions where they are chartered into two kinds. Number one, whether or not they can issue stock. May mga corporation talaga that they issue stock. Yun yung mga nakikita nyo sa mga stock market. Ano-ano ba? If I'm not mistaken, Jollibee Corporation ay nag-aano sila ng mga stocks. Okay? Tapos, I do not know if GMA Corporation, ABS-CBN Corporation, I think ABS-CBN Corporation. correct me if I'm wrong, you can comment down below about ABS Corporation if they provide stock, okay? So, whether or not they are also for profit. Number two, sure yon. Lahat ng mga corporations, they want profit. That's why they have that business. And ownership of the corporation is through stock. And owners of stock are referred to as stockholders. Okay? Corporations not allowed to issue stock are referred to as non-stock corporations. So there are two kinds of corporation. Yung mga stock corporations na nag-a-allow sila ng nag-i-issue sila ng mga stock sa stock market. And the other one is the non-stock corporation. Hindi nila ina-allow yung, hindi sila nag-i-issue ng mga stock. Kumbaga, napaka-private lang ng kanilang corporation. Sila-sila lang talaga ang dapat magmayari. Kaya hindi ko talaga lubos maisip kung talagang ABS-CBN ba corporation is also a stock corporation. Kasi kung hindi ako nagkakamali, si Bossy sa Itbulaga, isa sa mga stakeholder ng corporation, ng ABS-CBN, an Angel Locsin. I do not know if it is true. Based lang naman ako sa mga usap-usapan sa social media. Another one is cooperatives. Cooperatives, very familiar din ito sa Pilipinas. Or tinatawag itong co-op. Okay, co-op. So, ano ba yung cooperatives? Do you have an idea? So, kung wala, makinig ng mabuti, sa akin tatalakayin. Cooperatives is a legal entity owned and democratically controlled by its members. So, ibig sabihin, grupo rin ng mga tao ito na nagtayo ng business. Pero ano kayang pagkakaiba nito sa corporation kanina? Later, we will find out. Members often have a close association with the enterprise as producers or consumers of its products or services, or as its employees. Cooperatives often share their earnings with the members as dividends, which are divided among the members according to their participation in the enterprise, such as patronage, instead of according to the value of their capital shareholdings. Okay? So, yun ang isa sa kaibahan ng corporation kanina. Kasi yung corporation probably can be a small business. Ang corporation kasi, so dapat pang big time na siya, no? Cooperative, just a small business. Like, for example, a group of tricycle drivers, a group of at least 50 tricycle drivers, nagkasundo silang magtatag ng business. So, it can be a cooperative of tricycle drivers, di ba? Halimbawa, group ng mga mininista sa gilid na nakatira sa mga baybayin ng Pilipinas. Nagkaisa sila na magtayo ng business. So, cooperative ang tawag doon. And ang earnings doon ay paghahati-hatian based on their based on sa kinita ng kanilang business. Okay? So, yon. And cooperatives are dedicated to the values of openness, social responsibility, and caring for others. So, aside from nandun na sila, kumikita sila, nandun pa rin yung pagiging open nila sa isa't isa, and you have to be responsible for the group. And of course, you have to care for the members. Okay? Membership is open, meaning that anyone who satisfies certain non-discriminatory. So, open ang business. As long as nagkasundo kayo na lahat ng mga cooperative members ay magkaroon ng amount or contribution sa grupo ng 10,000, so magbabayad ka doon. So, just a small amount of money compared sa corporation kanina or corporation. Conditions may join. Economic benefits are distributed proportionally to each member level of participation in the cooperative. Okay? So, yun. proportion ang depende sa yung contribution sa kooperatiba. Okay? Another non-state institution is the trade union. I know you are familiar with this. Kung hindi man, makinig din ng mabuti. Trade union is an organization whose membership consists of workers and union leaders. So sino-sino yung mga members dito? Mga trabahador, yung mga workers, and the leader. Okay? They are united to protect and promote their common interest. So that's the function. Bakit sila nagkakaisa? Because they want to protect and they have to promote their common interest. Kapangalagaan ng bawat miyembro o kasapi ng trade union. Okay? So a trade union may be, one, a company union that represents interest of only one company and may not have any connections with other union. Okay? Number two, a general union that represents workers from several companies in the same industry. Let's say, for example, union ng mga nagtatrabaho sa call center. Okay? So, union ng mga nagtatrabaho sa factory. Okay? So, a craft union naman that represents skilled workers in a field. Itong mga craft union, ito yung halimbawa yung grupo ng mga union or union ng mga grupo ng mga gumagawa ng mga basket, okay, or grupo ng mga or union ng mga artist, yung mga halimbawa nagpipinta, yung mga nagdo-drawing, di ba? So yon. So now you have an idea about trade union. Okay. So, isang mga halimbawa ng trade union is dito sa Pilipinas, are you familiar with Kilusang Mayo 1? Nakikita ko sila usually kapag sona ng ating presidente, nasa Commonwealth Avenue sila. Mayroon silang mga dala-dalang mga tarpaulin. Ano ba 'yon? Mga parang tarpaulin or mga placards diyan. Kilusang Mayo 1. So, itaas ang sweldo ng mga manggagawang Pilipino. Parang ganon. So, another one is the Trade Union Congress of the Philippines or the TUCP. Isang napakalaking organisasyon to ng mga manggagawang Pilipino. Oo. Actually, nagre-represent na rin sila sa international. At saka yung Federation of Free Workers. Sorry. So yun. Yun yung mga organisasyon ng may kinalaman sa mga workers sa Pilipinas, okay? So another one is the Transnational Advocacy Group. Okay? So ano kaya itong Transnational Advocacy Group? Are you familiar with advocacy? Okay. So ito na yung mga may advokasya na buo yung grupo because they have advocacy na gusto nilang gawin while nagfa-function yung grupo na yon. Okay? So these networks are fluid and open relationships among knowledgeable committed actors like individuals and organizations. They exist to change international policy. Always take note of that. Bakit sila nag-exist? To change international policy, as well as make these changes real in day-to-day lives of ordinary people. So, like, for example, okay, their goals are to give powerless constituencies a voice in domestic and international law making. So, nabuo yung grupong yun because gusto nilang maging bosses ng masa. Okay? Mayroon silang mga ipinaglalaban. Diba? Mayroon silang layunin na baguhin yung sistema ng, let's say, for example, sistema ng government. Mayroon silang hindi nagugustuhan sa pamamalakad ng gobyerno. So, they are there to influence the lawmakers about about something that they really wanted to do. Now something is wrong with the policy, something like that. Okay. Examples of these examples of the kind of issues that motivate advocacy networks include ano ng mga halimbawa kung bakit nagbubuo ang mga grupong to. Human rights. Okay, lalong-lalo na ngayon, maraming nagsasabi, maraming mga human rights violation ang nagagawa ng ating gobyerno. Okay, consumer rights, lalong-lalo na ngayon, sobrang nagtataasan ang presyo ng mga bilihin. So dapat mayroong mga grupo ng mga taong kumukontrol or sumisilip sa pagtaas ng presyo ng ating mga bilihin. Women's rights, okay? So karapatan parang nilalayo nilang pangalagaan ang karapatan ng mga kababaihan sa ating bansa. Environmental issues, ang daming nangyayari sa environment. Nabuo ang grupong to because they wanted to protect the planet, the environment. International peace, okay? Gusto nila ng kapayapaan, not only in the Philippines but international. Okay? So, yun yung mga dahilan kung bakit namomotivate yung mga taong bumuo ng grupo or yung tinatawag natin na transnational advocacy groups. So, who participates in the transnational advocacy groups? Sino-sino yung mga sumasali dito? The national and international non-government organization or mga NGOs. Are you familiar with different NGOs in the Philippines? Ang dami. Local social movements, okay, foundations, mga different foundations, like for example, I am GMA Foundation, halimbawa sa ABS yung Bantay Bata program, Bantay Bata Foundation ba yun? So yun, okay, the media, they also, there are also some media practitioners na member ng mga transnational advocacy group. Religious organizations, the trade unions, and the consumers organizations. So, sila-sila yung mga nagpa-participate dito. The intellectuals and the scholars. Kayo, huwag kayong magugulat kung marami mga sinasabi ninyo, ang University of the Philippines ay puro lang sila panunulugsa sa mga baho ng gobyerno or something like that. Kasi, yan, sila yung mga tumutuligsa sa maling pamamalakad ng organisasyon. Agencies within international and regional intergovernmental organizations. And last, I think, parts of executive or parliamentary branches of government. Okay? So sila-sila yung mga nasumasali sa mga sa transnational advocacy groups. So another one is the development agency, another non-state institution. So ano ba itong mga development agencies? Familiar tayo dito, lalo-lalo na kapag may mga calamities na nangyayari sa ating bansa. Ang daming mga different developmental agencies ang narito sa ating bansa at handang tumulong. Okay. Development agency, CIS. This is a development agency. A development agency is an organization committed or dedicated to distribute aid. Many professional aid organizations exist, both within government. Like for example, the USAID or Australian Aid, the DFID, the European Aid, the ECHO. So sila yung mga development agencies na tumutulong kapag may mga calamities na nangyayari sa bawat lugar, sa bawat bansa. Okay? So between governments as multilateral donors and as private voluntary organizations or non-governmental organizations. So sila-sila ay mga private organizations or mga NGO din. Usually sila ay mga international organizations na tumutulong sa mga bansang nangangailangan in terms of money, financial, or para makabangon dahil sa kalamidad. Naalala niyo noon yung nangyaring nangyaring bagyo, yung Yolanda. Different developmental agencies ang pumunta sa Tacloban, sa Cebu, sa kung saan-saan man, sa Leyte and Samar. Kasi yun ang kanilang tungkulin. Okay? Aid can be subdivided into two categories. Pwedeng humanitarian aid, like for example, yung mga relief goods, mga emergency relief aid efforts, for example, in response to natural disasters, bumagyo, nagkaroon ng lindol, di ba? So nandiyan sila, yung tinatawag ng mga humanitarian aid na tulong galing sa mga different development agencies. And yung isa naman, yung development aid. Ito naman yung tinatawag ng mga foreign aid. So it aimed at helping countries to achieve long-term sustainable economic growth with the aim of achieving poverty reduction. Yung iba nga sa kanila, nagtatayo ng mga schools para sa mga public school sa mga probinsya. So, mga long-term ang kanilang tulong. Halimbawa, nagpro-provide sila ng money para makapagtayo ang isang pamilya ng business after the calamity. So, yun yung mga tulong na ibinabahagi ng development agencies. Another one is the international organizations. Sino-sinong mga to? An international organization is an organization with an international membership, scope, or presence. So, international. Hindi na lang to sa Pilipinas. There are two main types. International non-governmental organization or INGOs. Non-governmental organizations or NGOs that operate internationally. So, pang-international ang operations. Another one, number two, intergovernmental organizations, also known as international governmental organizations or the IGOs. The type of organization closely associated with the term international organization. These are organizations that are made up primarily of sovereign states or referred to as member states. Okay? Ano bang mga halimbawa ng mga international organizations? Like for example, the International Labor Organization or the ILO. Ang layunin naman nito is pangalagaan ang bawat miyembro na ang bawat laborers, hindi lang sa isang bansa kundi international. Okay, number isa pang halimbawa yung tinatawag na International Monetary Fund. Are you familiar with International Monetary Fund or the IMF? Ito naman sila ay nagpapautang ng pera sa bawat bansa na nangangailangan ng tulong. I think suki ang Pilipinas dito sa pangungutang sa IMF. Okay? Tapos yung United Nations or United Nation Organization. So, international din silang organization. Okay? So, yon. And that would be all. So, by the way, we have discussed the different non-state organizations. So, ano ba yung mga different non-state organizations? Pinakita ko kanina yung banks, corporations, cooperatives, trade unions, transnational advocacy groups. We also have the development agencies and the international organizations. So these are the non-state institutions. Okay? So ngayon naman class, I have here an activity. You are going to unscramble the following words and write your answers on the space provided inside the box. Write their functions / role in the society, either it is local or international. Okay? Dahil ngayon ay nandito tayo sa ating video lesson, if you have answers, you can also participate. Please do not forget to write your answers sa comment section ng ating video. Okay? So, halimbawa ito, number 1, number 2, 3, 4, 5. So, remember, take note, if you notice, these are unscrambled words. Scrambled words. These are scrambled words. So, ang gagawin nyo is, ano kaya ang word, halimbawa ng number 1? Then, sa box, write their functions. Okay? So thank you so much sa pakikinig sa aking lesson. Once again, if you have questions, please do not forget to write your question sa comment section ng ating video. Okay? And to my students, please prepare your question and do not forget and do not hesitate to ask questions during the lesson. Okay? So I'll see you everyone in my class. Once again, thank you so much sa pakikinig. Bye everyone.